and welcome to the Meet the Owner video on this 2007 Aston Martin Vantage. I'm here with Paul. Say hello, Paul.
Hello.
So, Paul, this car, tell us a little bit about it then, and you, in terms of how long have you owned it for?
I had it just under 18 months, and we were looking for a car that we could do touring and stuff in, so we bought it, and we've had a fabulous time in it, probably done only about 1,500 miles. Most of which was taken up on a trip down to the mall last summer, which was one hell of an experience. What a beautiful, beautiful driving experience. Being a manual and with those roads, we didn't go on any major roads at any time, which I think was great. In fact, it was roofed down all the time.
Was the weather good?
Well, it was fantastic. Yeah. Well, roofed down all the time, just lapping up the exhaust note and just enjoying the car and having a really good experience.
Cool. So you've owned it for, I think you were saying, about 15 months, or just under a year and a half.
Yeah.
Why did you buy it in the first place? What were you looking for in terms of this car?
Well, I'm ex-Jaguar, so I did a lot of development work on F-Type and XK, so I know quite a bit about them. And about that sort of car, performance cars, we just wanted something a bit different. We looked for an XK for a while, and then had a look at one of these and thought, actually, for what you get, it's actually exceptionally good value. You know, you get a car which looks stunning, it sounds amazing, and it's got all the charisma of being a really British thoroughbred. And the nice thing is, people like these cars, so when you pull up at the lights, you know, you don't get any animosity, which you can say, was it Ferrari or something. People like these cars, it's fabulous. Because it looked like good value in comparison with an XK.
It's beautiful, and it's of course it's super low mileage. When you look to buy this a year and a half ago, did you look at many others, or what was your sort of criteria?
I think we looked for about four, and the criteria was a bit about colour and a bit about mileage, and definitely the manual gearbox, because the manual just makes huge difference to that fun factor. And I think we saw about four, but you know, they were all a little bit, you know, they'd had paint done on them, or there was some issue on them, got dented rear bumpers, or they just hadn't been the kind of one we looked after. Whereas this is as near as done it, and for a car that's done under 20,000 miles, it's amazing.
Well, I spent a few hours with it, of course, consigning the car, so I've been all over it, and it is really exceptional. It's done 19, just over 19,000 miles, I believe. So if you're in the market, I guess, for history, then this has got to be the car, isn't it?
Yeah, full maintenance service history.
Yeah.
The service sort of last summer, and a full service including a transaxle oil change, which was quite expensive, but new tyres just before we went to the mall, so they're as damn new. On the front, and the rear tyres have got loads and loads of life left on them, matched Bridgestones as the car was made with.
Yeah.
And it's got a few other nice things. It's got optional 19-inch wheels, it's got cruise control, it's got a phone, obviously, and then the rest of it is standard air conditioning and stuff like that. It's got sat nav, which is works really well, and it's got a CD player, which is great. It's quite unusual in a car these days. It's got six CD changers.
And everything works as it should?
Absolutely, absolutely everything. Yeah, the car is totally fabulous. It's beautiful.
And why are you selling it now, then, I guess?
Well, it just hadn't got used enough. You know, you have these aspirations, don't you? The truth is, it just didn't get used enough. We did the trip down to the mall, and that is the lion's share of the mileage. The rest of the dust has been shorter journeys and just not getting used out of it. It seems to be a shame to have it sit about. So somebody else should enjoy it.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, well, Paul, thank you very much for showing us the car.
Yeah.
Everybody, as usual, if you've got any questions that you want to ask Paul, then please just pop them in the comments section at the bottom. Just scroll down to the very bottom of the listing, and Paul will reply straight away with any questions that you have. So, thanks once again, Paul, and thanks, everybody.